In this video, I'll show you how to load and display 32-bit bitmap image files with transparency with the C standard library. I'm doing this in a basic Windows program, so I'm linking to GDI32, but no extra linking is required for the bitmap code itself. I'm compiling with GCC. I've highlighted the code unrelated to this tutorial, which opens a window, copies the pixel buffer to the window, and lets the escape key close the program. I'll collapse that code. We need to include standard I/O to read files. I've created this sprite structure to hold the width, height, and pixels of our bitmap image. We use uint32s for the pixels since we're only going to be loading 32-bit bitmaps with alpha, red, green, and blue 8-bit subpixels. This is the same data needed for our window pixel array, so I'm using the sprite structure for that too. In the main program, we create the sprite variable and load it with this LoadSprite function, sending a pointer to the sprite to be filled with data and the file name to load. Here in LoadSprite, we find the bulk of the program. I found the bitmap file format information online and wrote it here in a convenient reference format. There are actually four versions of the bitmap format, but I've written this code to only work with version 4, which has been standard since Windows 95. There are also many variations of bitmap formats, such as 8-bit, using a color palette, and so on. But I've written code only to load 32-bit bitmaps with transparency. Bitmap files contain a file header identifying it, a bitmap header with information about the image, and the bitmap pixel data. Here I've declared all the variables we care to load from the file. Some of the data we don't care about, so we'll just skip it. I've interspersed several printfs to print out the data as we read it, just to make debugging easier. We create a file pointer and open the file in read binary mode. Check the file was opened successfully, then read the first two bytes with fgetc, checking that they're the letters BM, which identify a bitmap file. Note that I'm checking the data as we go with these if blocks and, on error, printing the error and setting the return value. Next, we read the variables we care about with fread, which takes a pointer to be filled, the number of bytes per element, and the number of elements to be read. We read image data address, width, height, and bit depth, with a couple of file seek operations to skip unneeded data. We verify the data address is as expected and the bit depth is correct before continuing. If the data so far is correct, we calculate our number of pixels and bytes per pixel and allocate the pixel buffer. We seek to the image data address and read the pixels. If read returns the number of elements read, so we check that matches our calculated number of pixels before finally setting our sprite's width, height, and pointer to the pixels. After the cascading error handling code, we close the file and return. Back in our main program, we proceed to the main program loop where we fill the frame buffer with a background, then copy the sprite pixels to the screen. I've used two different methods here. First is a relatively fast loop through each row of the sprite, using advancing pointers to copy each row at a time to the frame with memcopy. This doesn't process any of the pixels individually and so won't do alpha blending. Alternatively, we can loop through every pixel in the sprite and blend it with the background. We extract the alpha value and convert it to a floating point between 0 and 1. Then we extract the red, green, and blue values, shift them into the lower 8 bits, multiply by alpha, and shift back up to the correct byte. We do the same for the background, only using 1 minus alpha instead. Finally, we add the sprite and background color values together to get the blended pixel value. Note that this is very slow code and is written to be understandable, not fast. If you're rendering numerous transparent sprites in a game, you'll want to create far more optimized structures and algorithms to draw them. That's how to load and display bitmaps in C. In my next tutorials, I'll show you how to load sound files, do precise timing, and soon I'll be showing you how to make a complete small game in C. Cheers!